Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and today I'm hopping in to share a process video with you guys using the April Faith Heart Box from Creative Retreat Kits. As I mentioned in my last video here, I was waiting to have surgery. Well, I had surgery 5 days ago as of the filming of this intro. And so I'm trying to just do bits and pieces as I can. So bear with me. I wanted to do an entry that was reasonably easy and quick since I'm not feeling so great, but this will be a great option for those of you who maybe have kiddos, can't sit at your desk for multiple hours at a time, need to come and go and, you know, work on a page throughout the day. This is going to be the perfect entry for you guys, to try out. So what I have here is the devotional content from the April Faith Art Box, but I am going to be setting this aside and using this Devo. So this was a digital devotional that Creative Retreat came out with partway through the month. This is an earthly disguise. So this devotional content is different than the devotional content that's here in the card, but they do complement each other, which is really nice. So if you're finding that you're wanting to go a little bit deeper with these boxes each month, then this is a great add-on. Or if you are only working off of printables, you can get this in printable format, but then this gives you an alternative kind of method to work with the kit. So I love that there's, you know, just more and more variety coming to Creative Retreat's shop. So this is An Earthly Disguise by Christina Fox. It's camping out in Colossians 3:12. Says, put on then as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. And so we are talking about the humble brag and how, you know, we might be hearing humble bragging in other people. We might hear ourselves doing our own kind of humble bragging. We're all human. I'm sure we've all done it a time or two in our life. But we are talking about our new identity in Christ frees us from that spirit of bragging. We don't need to boast about ourselves anymore. Our identity is in Christ. And so I love how Christina takes us through this and kind of just gets you to think a little bit differently about the passage. I love that. And so this verse is a part of the verses that are studied in the devotional kit as well. So it's kind of nice. In addition to the devotional content, this printable Devo comes with a sheet of cut-aparts, which does include some really adorable journaling cards. I love this kind of library card style one there. And then there's also a sheet with these journaling spots and then a little prayer at the bottom. So plenty of pieces for you to play with, but it also pairs very well with the stickers and things from the Faith Art Box, which is what I will be doing today, is kind of mixing and matching. And so off camera, what I did was I took the prayer from that printable and actually typed it out on some of these journaling spot cards. And then I kind of mixed and matched some of the kit stickers in to replace some of the words in the prayer, just to kind of add some fun texture, add little pops of color. And then I used the alphabet stickers to spell out amen. So I already did that off camera. But what I really wanted to play with, since I'm missing my craft space, guys. And so I have been watching a ton of live demos and YouTube videos. And so there's this technique I've seen with crackle texture paste. And I'm going to be using embossing glaze, distress glazes, but you can also use embossing powders with this technique, but using the crackle paste through a stencil and then colorizing it with these powders. And so this technique does require that you walk away and let it dry. And so this is perfect for me because I can only sit at my desk for like 5 minutes at a time. And so this was perfect. I can set it up, let it dry, walk away, come back, and continue the page. And so if you do not have this particular texture paste, you really could do, you know, the same technique with any texture paste. You could even try, matte gel medium. You won't get the crackle effect, but you will be able to have some texture through the stencil that will grab a hold of the embossing glaze. I'm actually going to be using last month's stencils. This is the leaf stencil that came with the kit, and then this floral was an add-on. You know, I'm just trying to ease back into the crafty space, and florals make me happy, and so they're easy to create with, so I thought I would revisit these stencils. It does look like the leaf is still in stock, but the flower is sold out, but you really could do this technique with any stencil that you have on hand, including the stencil that was the add-on for this month's kit, is this cute little clothes hanger. But really, again, you could do this with any stencil. So let me go ahead and put you guys on fast forward and I'll walk you through how I'm putting together this entry in Colossians 3:12.
Okay, so I've grabbed the stencils I'm going to use, but again, you could do this with any stencil. And actually, the stencils with more open space really showcase this technique. But I grabbed the various elements and I'm kind of just staging things. And this is how I can ensure that it, you know, is kind of positioned how I want it to be positioned so that it looks like these leaves and the flower are kind of popping out from the left-hand side of the cards. So this is a good, just practical tip. Test things out. Don't just go at things willy-nilly. I'm going to use just a little bit of mint tape to hold down that stencil. And then I'm just taking a palette knife. Of course, it's been a while since I've done anything in here, so I'm like, oh, wait, got to put a piece of cardstock behind there to protect my Bible. But using a palette knife to just drag some of that crackle texture paste through the stencil. These stencils are nice because they aren't super, super thick, so this isn't going to create a super thick textured element in your Bible. It does have some texture, but it's not too bad. And then while that's still wet, it does stay wet for quite some time. I'm going to add in my speckled egg distress glaze embossing powder. And I did not prep the page with my powder tool first, which I probably should have, but that's okay. I can just go and brush any areas where there's powder that I don't want it to be, and then I can save this extra here back into the jar. So the powder is just grabbing a hold of that wet texture paste, and that is still wet. So I'm going to layer this flower, and you can see I'm kind of holding up that one corner because the texture paste is wet. So if I lay my stencil down on there, it's going to smush my leaves, and we don't want that. So it can be a little bit fussy. You just kind of have to take your time. Again, it would be much easier if you're using like one complete stencil image. Would be a little bit easier to do. And then you don't have to, you could use more than one color, but you could just use one color. It's up to you. But while that's wet, I'm going to go ahead and add in some embossing glaze. What I have on my texture paste there is just some press and seal to keep my texture paste wet. That's a little trick that Tim Holtz shared to get the most use out of your paste. So you can see I am tilting my Bible the other direction. That way the yellow doesn't brush off against the leaves because it will mix together. Now, if that's the look that you want, go for it. I've seen that look. It looks fantastic, but that was not the look I was going for here. I wanted the flower to be yellow, the leaves to be green. That way they match the colors of the kit. So just, you know, keep that in mind when you're getting rid of that excess powder. So that is wet and it has to air dry. So I walked away. I went and ate dinner, did some things, and then came back. And that allows the crackle paste to crackle. And then once it's dry, the powder no longer wants to really stick to the texture paste. So be very careful until you've heat set it, because if you tilt this page or move your Bible, that powder will just brush off the texture paste. So I'm carefully going in with my heat tool to now melt and activate the embossing glaze that is resting on top of the texture paste. I know it's kind of confusing, but it just think in layers. So the way that this texture paste works, because it's the crackle one, as it dries, it kind of pulls away from itself and creates all these fun little crack details. Much more noticeable in a, like I said, a stencil that has more wide open spaces, but it almost looks like broken glass. It just has this really neat texture. Now, I am covering up the words. If that bothers you, there are some alternatives you can do. You can stick to an interleaved Bible. You can stick to just doing this technique in the margin. Or if you used transparent texture paste, Ranger does have that, and then used the embossing glazes, which are transparent. Those are different from standard embossing powders. Those are unique line of powders that Tim Holtz does. Those are all transparent, so you should still be able to see the text through it. You just won't have that crackle texture, because I don't believe the crackle texture paste comes in a transparent. But I will list all the options down below in the description box for you guys, so you can, you do you, whatever works for your Bible. But now that's dry, it creates a resist. So I'm going in with some watercolors and adding some more color into these elements. Again, you could do this exact same technique with the add-on stencil. The little clothes hanger would be super cute. You use what you have and what you want to use. Like I said, I'm just super inspired with flowers and just really neat. I did not get enough playtime with these flowers last month. Now, I don't have a already made gray watercolor. I could make it, but like I said, I'm working on a time crunch. So I just pulled out a gray Neocolor 2 crayon and I'm adding some gray to the background. And again, just trying to tie in the colors with this month's kit. That way everything flows together. And this is a great way to inspire you guys to mix and match kits. Just because the month's over does not mean that you have to pack everything away and never use it again. You can see here I'm pulling out last month's stencils, using it with this month's kits. It's totally okay to do that. And so I hope this kind of inspires you to maybe use your stash, use some things that you have. So I'm just going in, and the Illustrating Bible is a little fussy with watercolor. So you'll see that I actually, right here, spray the page with some water, and that just kind of helps the watercolor blend a little bit. You do not want to overwork these pages in the Illustrating Bible because they will start to disintegrate. So just, you know, don't go in there scrubbing with your watercolors. You want to work pretty quick. Of course, it wouldn't be a Lindsay page without some Lindsay splatters. So I'm picking up the yellow, the green, and the gray and splattering that around just to kind of fill in the page. And then when I'm drying this, I'm just being careful not to go over the floral elements too much because I don't want to reactivate that embossing glaze. So now I've pulled out the Gargoyle Gray ink from Creative Retreat and one of the heart stamps from this month's stamp set. And I'm just going to add a little bit more interest to the background. So I'm actually doing third generation stamping. So I'm stamping this stamp, I'm inking it, stamping it twice on a scrap piece of paper, and then that third time bringing it to my page. And that gives me that really faint impression that kind of helps it blend into the background. Another great way to use your inks if you don't have a whole bunch of inks but want more colors or more shades of the colors, that is a way to, you know, it looks like I've got three colors of gray, but I don't, just one, just use multi-generational stamping. So I'm gluing down one of those journaling cards, the end of the prayer there, and then I'm going to layer this card on top and create like a little flip-up element. But I wanted to create a tab, so I'm pulling out some of the stickers from this month's kit. And it's bothering me that this heart is going to be layered funny with that heart stamp. And I finally just had to go, you know, Lindsay, it's the first time back in the seat in like 2 months. Just, it is what it is. Let it be. It does not have to be perfect. So hopefully that is, you know, encouragement for you guys. Your pages do not have to be Pinterest worthy perfect every single time. It's all about you and your time with God. It doesn't matter what the end result is. And so I have to let that go and not fuss over particular placement or just the right color shade or, you know, that kind of thing. I can't get caught up in that. It needs to be worried more about what I'm, you know, getting from the devotional content and the prayer and the time spent in God's word. That's more important. So you can see I used a little piece of washi tape to create that little flip-up element and that heart sticker. I just brushed my powder tool over the back of the area that was exposed. That would remove the stickiness. So now it acts like a little tab to grab a hold of. And then the page felt just not quite finished. So I'm pulling a combination of the stamps and the stickers to put a title up here. It's going to say, Clothe Yourself in Humility. And that's just was kind of a good reminder that I pulled from the devotional content, is just this having a humble spirit. And I, that is something that I honestly struggle with. And it's not even like I'm intentionally trying to be a know-it-all or trying to, you know, humble brag or do those things. It's just, it's my nature. I see it in my mom. I see it in my dad. Like, I'm sure it's like a learned trait that I've picked up. And so I'm trying to be better about recognizing when I'm doing that and trying to kind of grab hold of that and have a more humble spirit. So I had that as my title, just as my jump off reminder point there. And then as I sat back, I kind of felt like the flower and the leaves kind of got lost in that gray background. So I'm going in with a white gel pen and outlining the elements and just adding some highlights. And this really makes those images pop off the page. Again, if you're not wanting to cover text, you might want to skip this step because this is a pretty opaque white pen, or if you're working in, like I said, an interleaved Bible, a notebook, just stick to the margin. Definitely different ways that you can take my inspiration and adapt it for what works for you and what you like to do. I have about 20 other Bibles I can read from, so it doesn't bother me to cover the text a little bit in this particular Bible because it's only used for art journaling and prayer journaling. So just going to finish that up, adding those highlights. So I hope that inspires you to just maybe try a different technique. I don't know how many times I see different techniques on YouTube for card making or art journals and kind of want to know how to incorporate it into my journaling Bible. And so this is a fun way to take one of those techniques that I saw being used, you know, on cards and tags and things like that and incorporate it into my Bible. So if you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down below. Check out the description box for links to everything that I used, plus the other items that I mentioned as alternatives. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.